Hi, and welcome to Horn Trader on YouTube. Today, my special guest is a Vincent Bach Stradivarius Vindabona from the year 1968. Serial number is 38,533. Made shortly after they moved to Elkhart from the Mount Vernon factory. They moved in 65, so it's 3 years past that point, so they got all the kinks worked out. Still under the watchful eye of Vincent Bach. The Vindabona was designed to sound like the Viennese horns that Vincent Bach had known, and he named it the Vindabona. It's got a multiple bore personality. So what happens, it starts here with unmarked 43 pipe. It's 444 on the top leg of the tuning slide, 453 on the bottom leg of the tuning slide, goes all the way into here to 459 in the valve section, and then it comes out at the bell tail stub at 462. So you can see it's got a conical bore, very conical-ish, let's call it ish, conical-ish bore. These horns made back at that time were great horns and great time in Bach's history. Thicker brass, the two-piece valve sections, nickel-silver up here, brass down here, the nickel-silver slide outside legs. The horns were stamped so that the workers could keep track of what valve fit what instrument, so they put the serial numbers on them. Brass valve guides, heavy bracing. They even did something interesting with the bells, where they actually bent the bell so that the seam of the bell, where they brazed the bell, they seamed it together, goes and follows the line of the braces, and that's optimal for better vibration. So you can see a lot of thought was going into it. It's kind of hard to improve on an early Bach, Elkhart Bach. Mount Vernon was when they had brand new state-of-the-art equipment, but when they moved to Elkhart, they took all those workers that they were working with in Elkhart workers in Mount Vernon, and they took them to Elkhart. So now you got even better tooling, skilled workers, and Vincent Bach still watching over his namesakes. These trumpets are incredible. This one, you can see here, it's got a little bit of a scar from a repair. I think if it was re-lacquered, it would never show, but this is the original lacquer, and so this is what you get. You get what you get. Compression, not bad for a 48-year-old horn, I'd say. That's the third slide. Here's the first slide. Second pop. Third slide water dump works. I actually held down the valve, so it didn't make a pop. Let's see if we get the pop yet. Tuning slide works great. You see it's very clean. It was clean before it came to the Horn Trader. And I barely played it. It's very nice. Players like Wynton Marsalis and Brian Lynch played or started out their careers before moving to Monet on Vindabonas. And there's a reason for it. And it was the sound. I told you earlier that Vincent Bach wanted to get the rotary sound of the Viennese trumpets. So with this mouthpiece, hopefully I could demonstrate that sound. Very nice, dark, pure trumpet sound of the Viennese or Vindabona trumpet. With a cooler, hipper jazz mouthpiece, you get even darker. Sounding horn. You can find it in the vintage section of horntrader.com. Thanks a lot for listening. We'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.